हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस वीडियो इज़ अबाउट ऑर्डर निटेल्स ऑफ द डिवीज़न नीटोफाइटा इन जिम्नोस्पर्म. स्टूडेंट्स, एज आई एक्सप्लेन टू यू इन माई प्रीवियस वीडियो दैट डिवीज़न नीटोफाइटा इज़ क्लासिफाइड इन टू क्लास नीटोप्सीडा विच इंक्लूड्स थ्री मेन ऑर्डर एंड दीज आर निटेल्स, बेल्विशेल्स एंड एफिड्रेल्स. निटेल्स कंप्राइजेज ऑफ द फैमिली निटेसी which include genus Neetum having about more than 30 species. Similarly, Welwitschiales and Ephedrales comprises of the family Welwitschiaceae and Ephedraceae respectively. Students, in this video, I am going to explain you Neetales in detail. So let's know first of all some distinguishing feature of Neetum. Students, distribution of Neetum is restricted to tropical or subtropical and humid regions of the several countries of the world. Means they are generally present in the warm and humid places. Habit of Neetum in most of the species are lianas or tree, and only a few are shrubs and tree. You know very well, lianas are the buddy climber. Leaves of the Neetum are foliaceous, green and angiosperm-like. Venation of Neetum are reticulate and unicostate. Means there is one prominent vein from which venlets arises. Stomatal development of Neetum is syntochilic type. In this type of development, guard cells as well as subsidiary cells develop from the same single mother cell. Shoot apex of Neetum follows an open system growth and a definite tunica layer will be developed. Compound strobiles are calling and only very rarely terminal. Only a single prothallial cell is present in the male gametophyte. No striel cells and spermatogenous cells are formed in the young male gametophyte. Normal archegonia are absent in the female gametophyte. A free nucleus organizes some cytoplasmic material around itself and function directly as an egg. The upper portion of female gametophyte remains free nuclear at the time of fertilization and the lower portion becomes cellular. Endosperm of Neetum is like angiosperm, is formed after fertilization. As in the angiosperm, fertilization takes place in an embryo sac. In Neetum, there is no free nuclear division phase in the embryogenesis. A feeder is present in the embryo. As name indicate, feeder is a tissue which develop in the embryo to uptake nutrients. Haploid chromosome number of Neetum is 22. So students, let's know or understand these characters in detail. First is distribution of Neetaceae. Students, Neetum is represented by 40 species. According to Bhardwaj, in 1957, mainly 5 Neetum species are present in Neetum. First one is Neetum ulla. It is a woody climber having branches with swollen nodes. It is found in Western Ghat near Kandala, forest of Kerala, Nilgiri, Godavari, district of Andhra Pradesh and Odisha. Second one is Neetum contractum, a scandent shrub growing in Kerala, Nilgiri hills and Konnur in Tamil Nadu. Third one is Neetum nimon. It is a shrubby plant found in Assam. Next is Neetum monatum. It is a climber with smooth slender branches swollen at the nodes. It is found in Assam, Sikkim and parts of the Odisha. Next is Neetum latifolium. Student, it is a climber found in Andaman and Nicobar Island. As you can see in this image, you can see that reproductive organs are organized into inflorescence-like structure. Next is image of Neetum nimon. Student, you can see here male organ present in ring-like structure and these rings develop at the nodes. Next is habit of Neetum. Students, majority of the neetam species are climber except a few shrubs and tree. And neetam tree narvae is apparently a parasitic species. Two types of branches are usually present on the plant, that is branches of limited growth and branches of unlimited growth. Each branch contains nodes and internodes. Stem of several species of neetam is articulated, that is jointed due to presence of nodes. In climbing species, the branches of the limited growth are short nodes, are generally unbranched and wear the foliose leaves. The leaves are 9 to 10 and arranged in decussate pair, as you can see in this image, means they are present opposite to each other in a pair. They often lie in one plane, giving the appearance of a pinnate leaf to the branch. The leaves are large and oval with entire margins and reticulate venation, as also seen in dicotyledons. Some scaly leaves are also present. Students, you can see here reticulate venation that arises from the unicostate midrib. Next is anatomy of neetam. Students, you can see here images of the young root and mature root. Young root is without secondary growth and it resembles with the dicot. Layers of starch filled in the cortical cells. 4 to 6 layers of parenchyma, primary xylem, are visible. And xylem may be dyarch and exarch as in case of dicot. And you can see here dyarch xylem is present. In older root, that distinguishable due to secondary growth. And it consists of tracheid, basals and xylem parenchyma, as you can see prominently in this diagram. Phloem consists of sieve tubes and phloem parenchyma. Bar of sanio present in tracheids while they are absent in vessels. Students, you know very well that border pits and bar of sanio are characteristic feature of the gymnosperm. Next is young stem. TS of stem is circular in outline and resemble with a typical dicot stem. It has single layered epidermis that is thickly cuticularized. And it bears sunken stomata, as you can see in this image. The cortex consists of outer 5 to 7 cells with thick laurenchymatous region. Middle cells are parenchymatous and inner one is clerenchymatous region. Students, as clerenchyma are there, so stem is also supposed to perform photosynthesis, while clerenchyma provides strength to the stem. Several conjoint, collateral, open and endarch vascular bundles are arranged in a ring as in the dicot stem. You know very well, conjoint means both xylem and phloem when present in same radius. Collateral, phloem is outside and xylem is inside. Open means cambium is present and endarch, protoxylem is towards center. Students, xylem consists of tracheids and basals. Presence of vessels is an angiospermic character. Protoxylem elements are spiral or annular, while metaxylem show bordered pits, which are an extensive pith. Consisting of polygonal parenchymatous cell, phloem consists of sieve tubes and phloem parenchyma. So you can see here a prominent pith is present and it is similar as in the angiosperm dicot stem. This is image of older stem which develop after secondary growth. Students, in neetam nemon, the secondary growth is normal as seen also in the dicot. But in majority of the species like neetam, ula and neetam, africana, the anomalous secondary growth is present. And that is due to primary cambium is ephemeral, means short-lived. The secondary cambium in different parts of the cortex develop in the form of successive ring, one after the other. The first cambium cut off secondary xylem toward outside and secondary phloem toward inner side. This cambium ceases its function after some time. That's why we call that primary cambium is ephemeral. It grow or it develop for short period and perform its function by producing secondary phloem and secondary xylem and then ceases. Likewise, more cambium rings develop in peripheral position and perform their function of producing secondary xylem and secondary phloem. And in this way, a ring of the vascular cambium develop in the wood, which give appearance of neatum as a eccentric ring of xylem and phloem. The type of eccentric wood which develop in neatum is the characteristic feature of angiospermic lianas. The periderm is thin and develop from the outer cortex. It also possesses lenticels. The cortex also contain clonochromatous, parenchymatous and sclerenchymatous cells or tissues. Students, in tangential longitudinal section of the stem, the wood, xylem and medullary rays are visible. Bordered pits on both the radial and tangential walls are present. Medullary rays are either uniserrate or multiserrate, as you can see in this image. First one is medullary rays with multiserrate and second image has uniserrate type of medullary rays. Means in multiserrate many layers are present, while in uniserrate single ray is present. They are board shaped and their width varies from 2 to many cells. Sieve cells of the phloem contain oblique and perforated sieve plates in the old stem. The secondary wood consists of tracheids and vessels. Tracheid contain bordered pits on their radial wall, while vessels contain simple pits. Transitional stage containing one to many perforation in the terminal part of the vessels are also seen. You can see here perforations which develop in the tracheids. Next is anatomy of leaf. Students, anatomy of leaf also resemble with the dicot leaf. It is bonded by a layer of thickly cuticularized epidermis and bears stomata on lower surface. On whole the lower surface except on the veins. The mesophyll is differentiated into single layered palisade and a well-developed spongy parenchyma, as you can see in this image. Many stellately branched sclerates are present near the lower epidermis in the spongy parenchyma. Many stone cells and latex tubes are also present. Several vascular bundles in the form of arc or curve are present in the prominent midriff region, as you can see in this image. And these are conjoint and collateral. See, this is anatomy of leaf in neatum. Next is reproduction. Students, neatum is dioecious. The reproductive organs are organized into well-developed cones or strobili. These cones are organized into inflorescence like angiosperm, generally of panicle type. Sometimes the cones are terminal in position. Cone consists of a cone axis at the base of which are present two opposite and pinnate bracts. Nodes and internodes are present in the cone axis, as you can see in this image. Whorls of the circular bracts are present on the nodes. These are arranged one above the other to form a cupules or collar. The male flowers are arranged in definite ring above each collar on the nodes of the axis of the male cone. Students, as you can see in this image, there are nodes and internodes, and male flowers, they are arranged like a ring over the bracts, and these bracts form collar or cupule. The number of rings varies between 3 to 6. The male flower in the rings are arranged alternately. There is a ring of abortive ovules or imperfect female flower above the ring of the male flower, as you can see in this image. Each male flower contains two corant bracts which form the perianth, as you can see in this image. Bracts, they are fused to form perianth. Two unilocular anthers remain attached on a short stalk and closed within the perianth. So you can see here, these are the anthers which remain enclosed with the perianth at the base. At maturity, when the anthers are ready to descend, the stalk elongate and the anther came out of the perianth. Students, you can see again the images of the male cone. So bracts at the base, they are fused to form perianth, and anther are present above the perianth. Next is female cone. The female cone resemble with the male cone except in some definite aspects. A single ring of 4 to 10 female cones or ovule is present just above each collar. Students, you can see here bracts that is fused to form a collar, and 4 to 6 female flowers or ovule are present above the collar. Only a few of the ovule develop into mature seeds. In the young condition, there is hardly an external difference between the male and female cones. All the ovules are of the same size when young, but later on a few of them enlarge and develop into mature seeds. All the ovules never mature into seed, as you can see in this image. Out of all these ovules, only 2 mature into seeds. Students, as perianth or bracts are present in both male and female cone, so they give appearance of a flower. That's why sometimes they are also called as neatum, male flower or female flower, as you can see in this image. Internal structure of the ovule, and you can see here micropylar end, free nuclear part of female gametophyte, cellular part of female gametophyte, and outer, middle, inner layers, as well as nucellus, which provide nutrition to the developing female gametophyte. Next is seed. Students, neatum seeds are oval to elongated in shape and green to red in color. It remains surrounded by a 3-layered envelope which encloses the embryo and the endosperm. Outer envelope is fleshy and consists of parenchymatous cells. It imparts color to the seed. Germination of seed is of epigeal type, that is above the ground. Next is the origin of double fertilization and its significance regarding endosperm development. A series of studies of fertilization in nettles, considered to be close relative to the angiosperm, has shown that a primitive form of double fertilization occurred in this clade. In 2 species of the ephedra and neatum, pollen tube delivered 2 male pronuclei into a synocytic ovule. Each pronucleus fuses with the female pronucleus, which result into 2 diploid zygote. In ephedra, trifurca and neatum nemone, both zygote initially develop into an embryo, but ultimately only 1 embryo survives. This observation indicates that double fertilization is likely to have evolved earlier, before the divergence between nettles and angiosperm. The secondary embryo would have later evolved into a noble organism, the endosperm. In ephedra, the egg cell contains only a central egg pronucleus and a vertical canal pronucleus facing the micropyle. Ephedra is thought to have diverged early from other nettles, and thus may be more closely related to angiosperm. In all the gymnosperm except neatum, a cellular endosperm developed before fertilization. In neatum, the cell formation, although start before fertilization, a part of the gametophyte remains free nuclear at the time of fertilization. Next is neatum and other gymnosperm. Students, as neatum show close similarities with the angiosperm, so it is very confusing for the many taxonomists. But in very close relationship with the gymnosperm, that's why it is placed in the gymnosperm. And very similar characteristics of neatum and gymnosperm are both having tracheids with bordered pits. No companion cells are present. Presence of naked ovule. Absence of fruit formation because of the absence of ovary. Anemophilous type of pollination, that is bin pollination. Development of prothelial cells. cleavage polyembryony, resemblance of vascular supply of the peduncle of the cone of Cycadidae Bellendi with that of single flower of Neatum, resemblance of structure of basal part of ovule in Neatum and Bennett, Neatum and angiosperm. In a beautiful monograph on Neatum, Maheshwari and Basil have stated that Neatum remains largely phylogenetic puzzle. It is gymnosperm but possesses some strong angiospermic features. As follow, the general habit of sporophyte of many species of Neatum resemble with angiosperm. It has reticulate venation in the leaves of Neatum in an angiospermic character. Presence of vessels in xylem is again an angiospermic character. Clear tunica shoot apex. Strobili of Neatum resemble much more with angiosperm than that of gymnosperm. Micropylar tube of Neatales can be compared with the style of the angiosperm because both perform more or less similar function. Tetrasporic development of the female gametophyte is again a character which brings Neatum close to angiosperm. Absence of archegonia again brings Neatum and angiosperm much closer. Dicotyledons, nature of embryo of Neatum brings it quite close to dicotyledons. So these are the similar character of Neatum and angiosperm. Resemblance between Neatum, Ephedra and Balvischia, or you can say resemblance between the order of Neatophyta. All show opposite leaves, vessels in their secondary wood, similar structure and development of perforation plates in their vessels, similar Neatalian mode of development of their vessels by the dissolution of torus and middle lamella of the border pits, almost similar structure of their sieve cells and phloem parenchyma, spiral or annular elements in their protoxylem, arrangement of their flowers in compound strobili, unisexual flower, dioecious plants, stalked male flower bearing synangia that is made up of 1 to 6 or more sporangia, almost consistent structure of the walls of their microsporangia, beingless pollen grains, orthotropous ovule, ovule surrounded by several envelopes which are interpreted variously as integuments or perianth, extremely elongated micropylar tube, formation of unicellular primary suspensor, dicotyledonous embryo and simple type of polyembryony. So students, that's all about the characters of the Neatales. I hope you understood this topic. Thank you for listening.